Okay, now it wouldn't be K-pop if there wasn't some kind of big drama happening. This week is no different, and as always, I'm bringing you the freshest news. From Lisa's solo debut getting spoiled, Pledis Entertainment secrets getting revealed, to a K-pop producer facing a prison sentence. And let's not forget about the latest news about Big Hit's next boy group. Without wasting your time, let's get into it. Just when you think that everything's all rainbows and unicorns, something big happens again. This time, we are talking about a Korean producer and director who is facing some very serious charges. According to the article released by Naver, a certain Korean producer is being accused of indulging in a non-consensual behavior. The name of the PD has not yet been disclosed, however, it is suspected that it might be someone from a very big television network, such as KBS. This has not been confirmed though, but Naver revealed that this PD has directed famous entertainment programs of various genres, including variety shows, sitcoms, and public comedies, and won awards at the Korea PD Awards for his excellent directing skills. Now, as you can see, these allegations are extremely serious since it looks like this person was in a very high position in an undisclosed television broadcasting company and held a huge amount of power. The police began the investigation very quietly, and nothing has been said to the public until now. Many netizens think that this is a major issue because it looks like someone is trying to swipe the whole thing under the carpet, and that surely doesn't sit well with many of us. This producer-director has been allegedly ordered to stand by and keep his appearances and activities very low-key for the time being, since he may actually face a prison sentence. I will do my best to keep you updated. Okay, now what if I told you that we know how the new Big Hit group will look like? I mean, whether you refer to Bang Si-hyuk's company as Big Hit or HYBE, it doesn't really matter at this point because Mr. Bang has been dropping some accidental clues lately. There is a YouTube channel called Trainee A that has started to receive a lot of attention, thanks to all the rumors that the people in the videos of the channel are actually trainees for Mr. Bang's new boy group. The reason why many people consider these boys to be HYBE trainees is that the Instagram account that is linked to their channel is followed by various HYBE producers and Bang Si-hyuk himself. The channel also has a description in which you can find the names of the boys, and those are Leo, Sangwon, James, Jiyun, Junil, and Inhyuk. Now, I don't know about you, but I can already see my bias list getting wrecked by these boys pretty soon. Who else is excited for them? I personally cannot wait to see what the new HYBE group will look like because, let's be honest, Bang Si-hyuk set the standard with his current groups really high. As you have all probably heard, Blackpink's Lisa is made to make her solo debut in June this year. This information was revealed by Harper's Bazaar Thailand in one of their Instagram posts in the middle of April. Ever since then, the fans have been repeatedly asking for more info regarding this amazing project. However, YG Entertainment seems to keep their mouths shut. Well, YG might try to keep things very low-key this time, but the famous DJ Snake has totally spoiled it. Or did he really? In a series of now-deleted posts on Twitter, DJ Snake has talked to some fans and hinted that he indeed is working with Lisa on something. And after that, all the people just concluded that he's releasing a song with Blackpink's Maknae. When this huge Twitter tea got spilled, people remembered a post from 2019 that DJ Snake posted. In this tweet, the caption says, "DJ Snake and Blackpink in your area. It wouldn't be too much of a surprise if the song that Lisa is to release this June was recorded almost 3 years ago, since even Rosé's solo music has been pre-recorded way before it got released." A fan asked DJ Snake if he is coming up with a song featuring Lisa and Selena Gomez. He denied that, and when another fan asked him if he was putting out music only with Lisa, he replied with, "Yes." People got so excited that they basically spammed his account with questions, but DJ Snake only confirmed that the song is indeed done and ready to go. Some fans have taken this not in such a positive light though. Many think that he is clout chasing or just exploiting Lisa's fame. One person online said, "Who even is he? I've never heard of this guy, LMAO. Lisa's fine on her own and she absolutely needs no men to promote her solo." I think that DJ Snake is just too excited and he was not using Lisa's name for clout. He is very well known in the music industry, and this might only mean that Lisa's song is going to be a total bop. Just drop it already, queen. When it comes to problematic companies in K-pop, Pledis Entertainment is a very well-known name among them. This agency has been in the past accused of many terrible things, such as physically hurting their trainees, strictly punishing them, and forcing them to do things that they were not okay with. 17 are an amazing example of how mistreated a group can be in the hands of this label. The agency has been receiving a new wave of backlash these days thanks to Han So-hee. Well, So-hee is no stranger to drama. She's been known for various controversies, one of them being associated with Big Bang's Top, or even BTS's V. She has also been involved in the Wonho drama when he was leaving Monsta X. However, this time, she was asked on her Instagram what her training days were like when she was under Pledis Entertainment. And let me tell you, she wasn't holding anything back. So he said, "There would be days when I would have dance lessons for 4 hours straight. During the class, whenever you wanted to drink, you had to ask the teacher for permission. Pledis were just harsh." After that, she revealed what her schedule was like. "I would practice from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. and there were practice lessons on Sundays too. On Sundays, I remember it wouldn't start at 10 a.m. but 12 p.m. instead." So he also shared some secrets about the staff of the company. "If you ever get drowsy in the vocal room or you're seen playing on your cell phone, the head of the rookie development team would see all of that through CCTV in their room and they would come in the vocal room to watch after you. You can't even get sleepy. You have to have amazing skills. After work, on your way home, they will take a picture of your watch and send it to the Kakao talk room." Now, whether she's telling the truth or not, we cannot say, but these things seem to be legit. Many netizens reacted with their own comments. One fan of Newest said, "Newest also had it hard during their trainee days. They cut the CCTV line and ran away and slept at a hotel room that one of the members' dad booked for them." Another netizen reacted with, "Nuez's Jonghyun also said that he would sleep in the washroom. The most eloquent comment must be, it's a military academy. It looks like being a trainee under Pledis Entertainment is truly no joke. And one can only imagine what happens behind closed doors." Speaking of companies, SM Entertainment is currently taking their time with Red Velvet's comeback. It's been more than 500 days since these amazing girls released any music, and we're all still waiting. Recently, I have informed you that there is indeed a comeback planned. At least it seems like it. But some fans are really not happy about the whole situation, especially because it looks oddly familiar. Many people ask themselves a question, are Red Velvet just another FX? Many of you probably know, but FX has been the most neglected group by SM Entertainment, and their career has been marked by terrible mismanagement. When it comes to Red Velvet, except the mini album by Irene and Seulgi or Wendy's solo work, we have been left in the dark. The fans are extremely worried, saying things like, "I feel like SM is turning all their attention to aespa, and I'm afraid Red Velvet will be neglected like FX was." Or, "This is the same pattern as what happened to FX. It seems like SM just stops paying attention to groups after they mark their 5th year anniversary." In the Red Velvet case, people also suspect that this might have something to do with Irene's past scandals, since she has received a lot of fire for her alleged rude behavior. I just hope that SM won't make the same mistakes as they did with FX, because the last thing we need right now is to waste the potential of another amazing group. And since we are already on the topic about SM, it's only right to shed some light on aespa's Winter, who has been making headlines for her stunning visuals lately. The group is making their comeback, and the teaser pictures are beyond beautiful. It looks like their concept of being fierce and stunning singers is once again on point, because let me tell you guys, they look like some kind of game characters. And although most of the people absolutely love it, because come on, concepts like this are one of a kind. There are some who have a lot to say, and that goes especially for our girl Winter. In her teaser picture, she is rocking her new dark hair with bangs. Yup, seems like our girl Winter is about to slay this comeback. She's also wearing huge earrings, and the whole thing looks surreal. Honestly, this is one hell of a transformation. Now, some of the comments are super positive, like, "Wow, Winter is the final boss of this concept." And others are more on this side. "If only they got rid of the bangs." I mean, whatever your taste is. Aespas are about to take over the K-pop game, and all we can do is cheer for them. Anyway, that's all for me today. I cannot wait to read all of your opinions, so please, don't hesitate to drop your thoughts in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to keep up with all the K-pop updates. See you soon, guys. Bye!